What makes a god? Tell me, what makes someone or something divine? What makes us pause and think of something greater than ourselves? The Orokin once fancied themselves as gods, rulers of the Origins system, and entitled to all its bounty. Through continuity, they attained immortality. Through technology, they attained power akin to magic. Through force of arms, they attained dominion over all the worlds before their feet. But the Orokin forgot a simple fact about the nature of godhood, and what it derives its power from. In their arrogance and their desire to conquer, the Orokin ruled through fear and demanded obedience of their subjects. But they had forgotten the simple truth, that sometimes it is better to be respected than feared, and that divinity is often more easily given when one sacrifices for others and acts in service of those that worship. So it was with the Guardian of the Desert, with the people of Mars, and with their defender and deity, Inaros. Our story does not begin with the people of Mars and their forgotten sand-worn structures. Instead, it begins with one who would in most other instances exploit them, Baro Ki'Teer. Baro is one who would be best described as illustrious or haughty. This void trader only emerges for a short period of time on a bi-weekly basis. He values the Tenno as a clientele capable of acquiring the strange artifacts of the void, either through their own strength of arms or by trading with him. Baro's stock of items from the void is often acquired specifically from his runners and their expeditions, with Baro selling on the artifacts and treasures discovered without much thought. The opulence of Baro's trade has lent him great wealth, but it has also brought him to a place where he holds little regard for the cultural heritage of the wares that he sells. However, this time, Baro is about to embark upon a journey with you that will dig into his own heritage and into a culture of an old Martian people that worshipped a deity of sand and storm. Our journey begins with Baro contacting us and requesting our presence to assist on the Martian surface. It is time to go tomb raiding, and Baro will be our guide.
Oh my. You can feel the filth and grit in every breath. This desolate rock is the former colony of the backward-thinking sky worshippers. Their stories are worth as much as the sand around you. Nothing. The Grineer took pity on their miserable existence years ago, returning this so-called civilization to the sand. Yet for some elusive reason, their relics have become quite fashionable and thus valuable. Rare antiquities. That's why we're here. Ignore these glyphs. Nothing but nonsense about their so-called god king. Inaros, is it? How quaint. The only thing heaven sent from Inaros would be the prices relics fetch at auction.
Hush, hush, my little Doom. You don't need to be scared. There, there. That's right, shake out the sand. But remember, not all of it. And I'll tell you the story.
Tenno, what is this? How are you doing that?
Long ago, the lands of our colony were cursed. They were soaked in fear. The Golden Skymen would come and take our children away. Young and old alike cowered before them, afraid to lose their most beloved.
That voice! Tenno, stop this!
But then he came. The Fear Eater, the Sky Killer. He was called Inaros.
A burial vessel. It will contain precious relics. There, there, you're not defiling a tomb. You're creating wealth. Return to your ship. We must examine this vessel further. I could have never foreseen this. That vessel, it contains primitive etchings that seem to be a sort of blueprint. Was a Warframe entombed there? Look at it. It's exquisite. There's an inscription. Prove you are him. Destroy the ones who oppress. Destroy who? Does this smudged glyph represent some enemy? You'll have to carry that vessel into battle and prove yourself if we are to unlock these secrets.
The strange voice within the tomb seemed to unsettle Baro, but his objective seems clear. Study the artifacts and uncover their secrets, if only for the sake of appraising their value. The treasure recovered from the tomb is a strange vessel that appears to be a part of some ceremonial rite of passage, if Baro is to be believed. The glyphs on the vessel represent challenges to defeat oppressive enemies throughout the system, thus proving one's martial prowess and displaying that they are indeed worthy of Inaros' legacy. As we uncover more and complete the first of these rituals, we return to the tomb of Inaros and discover yet more about the god of the primitive peoples of Mars.
I'll be grateful when this is over. I cannot stand this barren place. Even the Orokin could not have enlightened these sand skates. Remember, we're here for relics, not stories. So I'd appreciate if you kept your Tenno-Soma Void resonance thing to a minimum. I've had enough of this culture to last a lifetime. Take the vessel to the door. What happens?
Little one, after this, you must sleep.
Not again.
Inaros began not as our king, but as our enemy. A warrior of the Golden Skymen. But for each child the Skymen took away, Inaros grew even more angry. Until one fateful night. Another child had been taken, and the villagers had gathered in a mourning circle weeping, until they heard a small voice. By the dunes, it was the child returned. As he approached, the people gasped in horror, as they saw that he was drenched in blood. His father rushed to the boy and embraced him, and saw that he had no wounds. "Whose blood is this?" he asked. The boy looked to the sky and said, "This is the blood of the Skymen. This is the work of Inaros. By the sand and the stars, the Skymen raged. They set upon Inaros with their armies, but none could prevail. For he commanded the sand, he commanded death. Inaros ate their fear and became stronger."
None of this could be true, could it?
"And so they left us and took with them our fear. On that day, Inaros became our king, and in a great whirlwind of sand, ascended to watch over us from his throne in the sky."
What if? It can't be. That voice. Return to your ship. I must collect myself.
From what the voice of the tomb tells us, the original Tenno that was linked in transference with Inaros decided to rebel against the Orokin. It is unclear if the timing of this might coincide with the moment where the Orokin were purged by the Tenno, or if this particular Tenno, the one that was controlling Inaros, rebelled before such a calamitous event. The lore surrounding this great purge is at current unclear and incomplete, and so we will have to wait and see if more of it surfaces at some point in the future. Regardless, the Orokin forces were fended off by Inaros, and it appears that this is the point at which the divinity behind Inaros was first pointed out and recognized, although we know this to be less of a godlike power and more of one simply derived from the void. After once again completing the trials of Inaros, we return to the tomb, although this time, Baro seems more keen to uncover more from the voice of the tomb, and seems very keen to defend it from any who might defile it.
"By the void, the Grineer have picked up our scent. They'll take me. It's Inaros. You have to stop these animals at once. So where is she? That voice. I think I need to hear the rest. I think I've needed to hear this for a long time.
In peace, and our little dunes were our own to keep. But the sands of peace are ever shifting. Years later, a plague came to the desert. The infested. Desperate, our people called out to the sky. Inaros! Inaros! But they could not wake him. And so, they were consumed by the ravenous horde. With all lost, the few remaining villagers gathered in the morning circle to prepare for the end, when suddenly, a storm rose about them. A colossal, spiral storm of sand, piercing the sky. The villagers huddled, trapped within the storm's eye, as the beasts charged them. In moments, the beasts were torn apart, and the infested plague was swept away, never to be seen again. As the storm subsided, the people ventured out into the desert, hoping to catch a glimpse of their savior, their beloved Inaros. They found his glorious metal body, broken and still, lying in the sand. Did they mourn? No, no. They knew his spirit had returned to the sky to watch over them once again. They gathered his body to keep it safe from thieves and raiders. They placed the pieces within the sacred vessels and entombed them in secret. Knowing that one day, Inaros would reclaim his body and rise again. So now, my sweet Dune, you have no need of fear. Take these grains and keep them under your pillow. Inaros will watch over you.
Find extraction. We're done here. The story isn't just a myth, is it? Look at this sacred vessel, one of four, just as she described. And the challenges. You must prove your Tenno.
Inaros' sacrifice for the people of Mars explains a great deal. It speaks to the horror of an infested outbreak on the planet, and how the people were defenseless without assistance. With all that we now know, I wonder if the infested were always on Mars, or whether they came from the nearby infested moon of Deimos. Regardless, Inaros gave his life for the people under his protection, and made certain his position of godhood in their minds. Not through taking, but instead, through giving. Baro seems to be at peace, having heard the voice repeatedly. But upon our final entry into the tomb, we shall stumble upon a revelation that will change our understanding of Baro completely. It will explain his sudden desire to defend this place, his fondness of the gentle whisper of the tomb, and his seemingly newfound reverence for the Warframe known as Inaros.
Quickly, quickly, my sweet Dune, they're coming.
I tried so hard to forget.
In here. Don't make a sound, Baro. Here, hold these grains in your hand tight. Inaros will protect you.
It wasn't me I was worried about.
What do you want? No, you have no right.
Inaros. Inaros. Inaros.
No, no, it's just me.
Inaros. Inaros.
No.
But Inaros never came. You've shown me why I came here, Tenno. Not for riches. The doors are closing again. Prove that you're worthy of Inaros' strength one last time. My mother's call will be answered. Inaros will rise again. Come home, Tenno. She was gone, but somehow you let her speak again. You made me face my past. made me remember who I was. Take his relics and let him rise again. I couldn't think of selling them anyway. For me, these few grains of sand are all the treasure I need. Both of us know why Inaros couldn't have saved her. He wasn't able to listen then, but things are different now. Am I right?
Within the tomb, Baro rediscovered his childhood and found closure on what must have been the most traumatic event of his life. All the while, we did not come out empty-handed either. We gained the knowledge and power to construct one of the most important warframes in the history of Mars. The God of the Sands has risen again, and none too soon. For on the horizon, the plague that Inaros once fought is rising once more. The strains of the infestation have grown ever stronger and ever more persistent. Soon we shall return to Deimos, and soon we shall once again have need of Inaros' strength.